surreptitiously. Querelle was standing with his back to him in front of all of the sailors who were lying stretched at ease, merged into one large lump of virility. The lieutenant was just in time to see him flexing his powerful legs in their white ducks, hands on buttocks, in the fact of straining every muscle in the effort. He could imagine the high color of the maculate face and the anticipatory smile as he waited for the great relief, his eyes bright and a set smile on his lips. The culminating effort that would unloose down, wind a series of loud farts, short, sharp, and dry, as though the famous white ducks, Querelle called them his farting gales, had been rent from top to bottom, a performance to be greeted by a thousand cheers and streaming waving, and a burst of laughter from his mates, shocked to shyness. The lieutenant quickly averted his head and turned tail. Querelle performed the most dangerous of his crimes without wittingly or willfully committing an error, but no sooner he had committed a theft, a murder even, than he had perceived the nature of his error, sometimes in his errors, which had slipped into unawares.